You may have noticed at your local GP surgery, at public health events or promotions, a poster called the Eat Well Guide. This has been devised by Public Health England to help the nation eat more healthy, balanced meals. Whilst this all sounds great, how do we actually put this into practice for our own individual needs? Let's break it down to highlight key points to help you use this guide to lead a healthy, more balanced lifestyle. My first tip is to base your meals around starchy carbohydrates. This food group, bread, rice, pasta, and other starchy carbohydrates, is where you get the body's preferred source of energy. Ideally, these foods should make up a third of your plate at each meal, and we should aim to have 3 to 4 portions per day. One portion would roughly be the equivalent of 2 handfuls of uncooked pasta and rice, and from a cook's perspective of pasta and rice, 2 hands cupped together would be 1 portion. And finally, a baked potato the size of your fist would be 1 portion. Where possible, you should opt for whole grain bread, pasta and rice. This will increase your fibre content and help you feel fuller for longer. Foods in this food group also provide you with some B vitamins, which help the body to release energy from carbohydrate, protein and fat. The next food group is fruits and vegetables. Not only do these foods provide us with vitamins and minerals, which help us sustain bodily functions and immune health, they also provide us with fibre and sugar in the form of fructose. While sugar has been given quite a lot of bad press over the years, it is also important as part of a healthy, balanced diet. There is quite a difference in gaining sugar from fructose in fruit and confectionery, which provides you with no other nutritional value. My second tip is to aim to incorporate at least 5 fruit and vegetables a day into your meals. This has been widely publicised, with the benefits still standing true to today. You should also aim to consume a variety of colours, as this will maximise your vitamin and mineral intake, as different colours provide varying amounts of vitamins and minerals. For you as an individual, 1 handful is roughly 1 portion. This includes fresh, frozen, and tinned in fruit juice. Dried fruit is roughly 1/2 handful. Fruit juice and fruit smoothies will only amount to 1 portion, no matter how much you drink. One thing you will need to be mindful of is what you add when cooking your vegetables, as this may add extra calories without you realizing. Dairy and alternatives are an important part to a healthy, balanced diet. We should aim to have 2 to 3 portions of this food group per day. A portion of 30 grams of cheddar cheese, which is roughly 2 thumbs clasped together, 3 teaspoons of soft cheese, 200 milliliters of milk or 125 milliliters on cereal, and a pot of yogurt is classed as 1 portion. Foods in this group provide us with a great source of calcium, protein, minerals such as iodine and vitamin D. Often foods in this group tend to be high in fat, particularly those of animal sources. Therefore, my third tip is to opt for lower fat options. For example, adults and children over 5 should opt for semi-skimmed or skimmed milk. Dairy alternatives may be lower in fat, however, you do need to ensure that they have the same nutritional value. Therefore, it may be a good idea to look on the back of pack. Often these foods are fortified. Protein has been a prominent fixture in the media from a sustainability point of view, trend diets and sports nutrition. Much to many nutritionists' frustration, as daily requirements and sources are often misperceived. Historically, protein has always been seen as predominantly meat sources. However, it is in an array of foods and not just in this food group we call beans, pulses, eggs, fish, meat, and other protein foods. In recent years, plant-based proteins have gained a lot more prominence. The average male requires 56 grams per day and 45 grams per day for females. This can be easily achieved through eating 2 to 3 portions of this food group per day. 1 portion is roughly the equivalent of a piece of chicken around 1/2 the size of your hand, 6 tablespoons of lentils, beans or pulses, 2 rashers of bacon, 2 eggs, or 1/2 a tin of beans. Proteins are made up of amino acids, which are the building blocks to maintain health. So my fourth tip is to ensure you have a variety of proteins from both animal and plant sources to ensure that you get a good mix of amino acids. This will ensure that you also get the other nutrients you get from this food group too, such as iron from red meat, your omega-3 and omega-6s from your oily fish, and your B vitamins from your beans and pulses. You should opt for leaner cuts of meat as these tend to be lower in saturated fat. Saturated fat increases your blood cholesterol, which increases the risk of heart attacks and stroke. You should also opt for fish 2 to 3 times a week, one of which should be oily, as these provide your omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids, which help reduce the blood cholesterol. The fifth group is fats and oils. This is the smallest group of the Eat Well guide, mainly because these foods are more used for cooking than eating. Animal varieties such as butter, lard, and ghee tend to be higher in saturated fat. Therefore, my fifth tip is to opt for the plant varieties such as olive oil, vegetable oil, and rapeseed oil. Interestingly, rapeseed oil actually has half the amount of fat than olive oil. However, science always has exceptions to the rules. Whilst coconut oil is plant-based, it contains 82% saturated fat, and therefore intake should be limited. This covers the 5 food groups of the Eat Well Guide plate. However, to maintain a healthy, balanced diet, the Eat Well Guide also touches on some other key points. Foods and drinks high in fats and sugars sit outside the Eat Well Guide plate. This is because we should consume them sparingly. Not only do they include crisps, sweets, and chocolate, they also include some takeaways. It is okay to still have a treat every once in a while, however, not every day. So tip 6 is to allow yourself to have that treat. However, if possible, opt for the healthier option. This could be opting for wedges instead of chips, sharing a pizza rather than having a whole pizza to yourself, opting for a smaller portion, or perhaps portioning out the sharing bag of crisps to stop the temptation of eating the whole bag in one go. It is important to keep our fluid levels topped up, as not only are we approximately 2% dehydrated before we feel thirsty, but it also affects both our physical and mental performance. You should be aiming to drink 6 to 8 200ml of fluid per day. Milk and 150ml of fruit juice and smoothie also contribute to your fluid intake. This would mean you could have a double whammy of maintaining hydration whilst either contributing to one of your 5 a day or a portion of your dairy or alternatives food group. It is important to drink little and often throughout the day. So tip 7 is to consider what you drink, as this can also add to your daily calorie intake. Opt for diet and zero drinks, and also don't forget about good old water. My final tip, tip 8, is to read the front of pack reference intake labeling, in particular the per 100 gram guidance, to choose healthier food. The per 100 grams energy values help you compare the calories of similar products to help you choose the healthier option. Whilst the fat, saturated fat, sugar, and salt are shown per portion, the traffic light colors on some packs are actually figured out per 100 grams, making it easier to compare similar products. If you would like any further information and guidance on nutrition and well-being, check out our other videos on the We Are ESS channel.